แนวคิดเรื่องของกระจายความเสี่ยงในการลงทุนนะครับหรือว่า asset allocation นั้นเป็นสิ่งที่หลายคนอยากทำครับแต่ว่าทำด้วยตัวเองนั้นก็ค่อนข้างที่จะยากทีเดียวโดยเฉพาะสำหรับนักลงทุนที่มีเม็ดเงินค่อนข้างจำกัดนะครับแต่ว่าวันนี้ครับทางด้านของบลจ.กรุงศรีนะครับมีอีกหนึ่งทางเลือกในการกระจายความเสี่ยงแบบลงทุนทั่วโลกนะครับแล้วก็รับผลตอบแทนเป็นรายเดือนด้วยติดตามในสัมภาษณ์พิเศษชิ้นนี้ครับ
จะเป็นนักลงทุนที่ได้รับผลตอบแทนอย่างมั่นคงในยุคปัจจุบันถือเป็นเรื่องที่ยากค่ะดังนั้นนะคะการลงทุนในกองทุนที่มีผู้จัดการกองทุนคอยดูแลผลประโยชน์ให้อาจจะเป็นทางเลือกที่น่าสนใจไม่น้อยเลยค่ะวันนี้นะคะมีกองทุนใหม่มานำเสนอค่ะเป็นกองทุนจากบลจ.กรุงศรีชื่อว่ากองทุนเปิดกรุงศรี Global Multi Asset Income HFX หรือชื่อย่อว่า KFM Income ค่ะมีนโยบายการลงทุนนะคะกระจายการลงทุนไปทั่วโลกมีโอกาสได้รับผลตอบแทนเป็นรายเดือนค่ะเพราะว่าลงทุนในกองทุนหลัก Fidelity Funds นะคะความน่าสนใจของกองทุนนี้จะเป็นอย่างไรนะคะไปเจาะลึกกับมิสเตอร์จูดรัมโบซึ่งเป็น Multi Asset Investment Director ของ Fidelity International ค่ะHello, Mr. Stewart. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
Now we start from, in your opinion, what the challenge facing the investor today?
Yeah, investors face potentially the hardest market environment they have for several years, a period of low interest rates, and more recently, a global upswing in the economy has fueled an equity bull market for the last 6 years. And now equities are at their highest valuations in over a decade.And our indicators are suggesting that momentum in the global economy has probably peaked. And that means we're probably in the late stages of the bull market, which are traditionally very difficult to navigate. In these sorts of times, investors often start to look towards the safer assets, such as fixed income. But their valuations are also, or good value is also very hard to find. The central banks around the world,have been very cautious in rolling back their monetary policy accommodation, despite the fact we're seeing healthy levels of inflation. And that means that today's environment is actually difficult for income and growth investors alike.
Is there any solution to tackle with those challenge?
Yeah, we think that investors that are focused on achieving a sensible balance of income and growth can do two things.Maintain a very highly diversified portfolio of different assets,
yes.
And also a flexible asset allocation. Perhaps the easiest way to do this is through a multi-asset strategy that focuses on growth, income, and also, importantly, stability. So in this instance, investors would hand over the difficult asset allocation decision to an expert portfolio manager that has all of the tools at their disposal to deal with this challenging environment.And that way they can benefit from a strategy that is truly focused on delivering an outcome that is not tied to a specific benchmark or asset class, that is a one-stop shop for having a diversified portfolio across a wide range of different assets, both traditional assets and non-traditional assets, and also has the flexibility to adapt to a changing market environment to seek out the best opportunities for growth and income while maintaining stability byfocusing on low volatility and mitigating the risk of a performance drawdown.
So how could you achieve this, or what makes you different from the other?
So we start by giving multi-asset strategies the broadest universe of investments possible. What we're looking to do is have many different building blocks, and we believe that's the key to generating an outcome-orientated portfolio in the most diversified way.
Yes.
So many building blocks that do different things at different times in the economic cycle. Mm-hmm. So that's where we focus our research. We invest across the broad range of traditional asset classes, all corners of the earth, across countries, regions, sectors, currencies, and then we look at the best way of expressing our view in those different areas that we're focused on. And we're not wedded to a particular way of investing, so we look at active strategies, we look at passive strategies, long, long, short,and internal strategies as well as external strategies. But we don't stop there. We also invest in non-traditional asset classes, which give us a source ofperformance that is lowly correlated to the traditional asset classes, which is so important when we look across equities and bonds and valuations look quite rich. Finally, risk management is at the heart of everything that we do, making sure that we're not just focused on delivering the outcome, but we're controlling the journey to that outcome as well. So we always ask ourselves, what could go wrong? What if? Making sure that we mitigate the downside risks in a very difficult investing environment.
And what is your outlook going forward? Does income investing still important?
I think income investing is going to remain important for a very long time.
For me too.
For a group of investors, clearly it fits in with their financial goals, in that earning a current income is very important to what they're trying to achieve, such as those investors in retirement. For others, actually, it's a very efficient way of growing their wealth. So through the power of compounding, they can reinvest dividend income and achieve a higher total return. And I think when we look at valuations in markets and the fact that we expect lower returns going forward with higher volatility, many more investors will turn to income strategies in order to grow their wealth. And the question is right now is where can they find value in markets? And there's three areas where we think we still see good value. It's emerging market local currency debt, and financials and loans. Mm-hmm. Within emerging market local currency, we're in a little bit of a sweet spot. Emerging markets are benefiting from the global growth environment. Current accounts are in good shape. Inflation is low. And they're benefiting from just a gradual rise in the US dollar over the long term, we think. And as a result of this, we're seeing good inflows into the asset class. And emerging market debt local currency is actually delivering a yield of around 6% at the moment. So we think that that represents good value for investors seeking income in a diversified portfolio. With loans, at the moment, we see value there. Yields are in the region of around 5%. The interesting thing about that is that's quite similar to the type of level you see on high yield bonds, but yet loans are higher up in the capital structure, which means they're safer in the event of default. And the second thing with loans is that their coupon payments are linked to short-term interest rates. So when we see interest rates rise, we're actually seeing the income on these investments rise as well. And finally, financials represent good value because although for the last decade they've been disappointing in terms of performance, we're starting to see a reversal of the factors that have contributed to that underperformance, in that with rising yields, we're seeing stronger net interest margins, which is helping profits, stronger loan growth as well from an improving global economy. And also trading books within financials look okay as well, mostly on the equity side rather than fixed income. So overall, those are the three areas where we think represent good value, although again, within a diversified portfolio.
ถือว่ามีกลยุทธ์การลงทุนที่น่าสนใจทีเดียวค่ะกับกองทุนเปิด KFM Income เพราะว่าลงทุนในกองทุนหลัก Fidelity Funds นะคะซึ่งเป็นกองทุนจากบริษัทจัดการกองทุนระดับโลกค่ะถ้าคุณผู้ชมสนใจลงทุนนะคะเรามีช่วง IPO ค่ะคือวันที่3ถึง9สิงหาคมนี้ซึ่งการลงทุนทุกๆ 100,000 บาทนะคะจะได้รับมูลค่าหน่วยลงทุนเพิ่มอีก100บาทค่ะคุณผู้ชมสามารถสอบถามข้อมูลเพิ่มเติมได้ค่ะที่บลจ.กรุงศรีหรือธนาคารกรุงศรีทุกสาขาค่ะโทรเข้ามาก็ได้ค่ะที่เบอร์02657-5757 หรือ www.grungsiasset.com ค่ะ It's time to say goodbye and thank you very much for your information and your opinion today.
Thank you for having me.
ปิดท้ายกันไปด้วยการเชิญชวนนะครับคุณผู้ชมนะครับไปเที่ยวงานมหัศจรรย์แห่งไหมไทยครับ Wonder of Thai Silk นะครับจะจัดขึ้นในวันที่11ถึง13สิงหาคมนี้ที่ลาน Lifestyle Hall ชั้น2ศูนย์การค้าสยามพารากอนนะครับส่วนรายการวันนี้หมดเวลาลงแล้วนะครับผมพิชยุทธ์จงใจพิพัฒน์และทีมงานทุกคนลาคุณผู้ชมไปก่อนนะครับพบกันใหม่ในวันพรุ่งนี้สวัสดีครับ